Jordan, is this basically what we call a negotiated settlement that doesn't require the courts to get involved, or what?
Well, yeah, it's a dispute resolution process. There are other dispute resolution processes, but this one is quite different. Involves different people than you're used to seeing. We've got a mental health facilitator who basically manages the team meetings. We've got a financial professional. Even in our pro bono case that we recently did, we had a financial professional who brought money to the table that these folks didn't know that they were entitled to.
Okay,
and,
now
and the lawyers.
Is the part of the catch that both parties have to agree to do this?
Yes. The judge's hands are tied in court,
uh-huh.
but not in collaborative. The judge isn't involved, and the people can agree to whatever they want to agree to as long as it's legal.
Okay, now let's talk about some of the things you say are the advantages. Number one, you say it's a safe environment. How is that?
Well, you've got the facilitator who's there who is specifically attuned and watching for people talking about positions, not interests. In other words, even in mediation, people tend to say, I want the house, I want the house, I want the house. The facilitator says, wait, 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 what is it about the house? And we talk about what it is about the house,
mm-hmm.
the interests. I want my kids in a good school, in a good neighborhood, near their friends. I want a home office. I want room for a home office. Okay, now we're not talking about this particular house. We're talking about your interest in this house.
Uh-huh.
And how can we negotiate
that? These
are
not easy
things. When you file in court, the first thing that happens is you're at war. It's war from the get-go.
Because isn't this actually just like a contract?
It is a contract. That's exactly right. The only reason we go to court is because we're required to get a judge to give you a final judgment or you're not divorced. But there are other disputes you could resolve with just a contract that wouldn't require going to court, but those are not divorce disputes.
Now,
so the lawyers have to quit. The parties have to find lawyers who will go to court for them.
Okay,
it's a paradigm shift. Mm-hmm. It's a different way of thinking. Adam is my teammate. Even though he's my adversary,
mm-hmm.
he's my teammate because we both have the goal of getting these parties to a collaborative divorce end goal. In a normal courtroom setting, it's controversy, it's adversary, it's always we're against each other, always.
So of the 100 divorce lawyers that are out there, how many are into this collaborative stuff?
We have 4,000, little over 4,000 HCBA, Hillsborough County Bar Association members.
Uh-huh.
We have 150 members of the two practice groups, and 50, maybe 100, are lawyers. So 100 out of 4,000.
You say collaborative dispute resolution, and he says, not for me. You need to be looking for, like, you two.
That's
absolutely.
Right. That's right.
All right. Cool. Thank you for stopping by today. Appreciate it.
Well, thank you
so much.